Decision support systems for anesthesia in the operating room. Anesthesiologists in the operating room have to provide direct patient care. Anesthesiologists are considered the pilots of human biosphere, and terms like takeoff and landing for the process of inducing anesthesia and reversing it are very common, since these are the two dominant and critical moments of anesthesia. Often, maintenance of anesthesia receives less attention. To assure safe and good patient care during the surgical procedure, an anesthesiologist interacts with several devices. He becomes the mediator between patient and machine while the machine is mediating between patient and anesthesiologist. All are hybrids in action and each is unable to act independently. It is impossible to consider the anesthetic work without machines, just as it is impossible to imagine a pilot without his joysticks, buttons and computers. Decision support systems for anesthesia in the milieu of the operating room are software shaped to assist the anesthesiologist in his difficult work during the surgical procedure. Let's divide DSSs for anesthesia in the operating room into three classes: DSSs designed for perioperative use, DSSs for one single intraoperative problem, simple DSSs, and DSSs for multiple problems, complex DSSs. In his everyday activity, the anesthesiologist deals not only with patient-related issues, but also with many kinds of organizational problems, like strictly hierarchical command structures or deficits in providing important drugs or devices that can cause serious accidents. Reason has proposed a scheme of the development of an organizational accident. It is not possible to consider the anesthesiologist's responsibility only during the surgical intervention, as a pilot has to control his systems before the flight. Anesthesiologists must continuously assess the patient's status, from preoperative assessment till postoperative care. As a commander-in-chief, he has to make the final check of everything anesthetic in the operating room, despite the presence of nurses or respiratory technicians. One type of DSS can deal with organizational problems in order to prevent accidents. The first example of how DSSs may improve safety in the operating environment is a DSS which generates dynamically configured checklists for intraoperative problems. It is interesting that the database built with 600 entries of two anesthesia text courses and organized in problems and corresponding abnormalities, considers also technical hitches, like for example inefficiency in anesthesia machines or incorrect position of an endotracheal tube. For each abnormality detected by monitors and confirmed by the practitioner, the software formulates a list of questions, starting with a recognized high-impact abnormality, every abnormality uniquely associated with a problem. Questions about the high-impact abnormality are presented to users as closed-type questions, i.e. they can be answered as yes or no, to facilitate a quick response. The development of an organizational accident. Preoperative tests are crucial for the stratification of the anesthetic risk, for the choice of the anesthesia technique, but also to define the anesthesiologist's behavior. A Canadian group found that the mean cost of investigations was reduced from $124 to $73 if data for patients were assessed by staff anesthesiologists. Another study demonstrated that, following definite preoperative diagnostic guidelines, possible savings per 1,000 patients would be €26,287 and €1,076 if duplicated tests were avoided. A DSS for this purpose, the System for Preoperative Test Selection, SPOTS, has been developed to assist physicians in selecting the right preoperative, individualized and clinically relevant tests. The software uses a database comprising of patient data, clinical history, a list of surgical procedures, standard guidelines for preoperative investigations, type and cost of investigations, and investigation results. The DSS then suggests the test and performs a cost comparison. Airway management represents one of the most important challenges for the anesthesiologist. The main causes of anesthesia-related mortality are respiratory and cardiocirculatory events. One of the most important aims of preoperative assessment is predicting a difficult intubation. It means to timely prepare airway devices to facilitate a possibly difficult procedure. Currently, the gold standard for the evaluation of the difficulty of intubation is the Cormick and Lahan classification, but it's feasible only through direct laryngoscopy. A DSS for estimating the Cormick classification was presented in 2009. It was based on data of 264 medical records from patients suffering from a variety of diseases. It used 13 basic anthropometrical features to predict easy, Cormick 1 and 2, or difficult intubation, Cormick 3 and 4. The system showed an average classification accuracy of 90%. The 13 variables for Cormick classification and their encoding schemes. BMI, for body mass index, TMD, tyro mental distance, AOJ, atlanto-axial joint, EEG, inter-incisor gap, MMT, modified Mullen-Potty test. Binary values, 0, 1, were used for variables with only two attributes. Values as 0, 0.5 and 1 were used for variables with three attributes. Values as 0, 0.33, 0.67, 1, were used for variables with four attributes. Anesthesia Information Management Systems, AIMS, can reduce the anesthesiologist's workload. Implementation of DSSs in AIMS represents a natural evolution of information technology. DSSs can use data stored in AIMS to give diagnostic or therapeutic messages. This development increases the usefulness of both systems. Percentage of patients involved in prophylaxis. Statistically significant difference. A recent example of how a DSS combined with an AIMS can improve performance and outcomes is shown in a study about automated reminders for prophylaxis of postoperative nausea and vomiting, PONV. A database was implemented with PONV prophylaxis guidelines. The comparison of two groups, one with only AIMS and the other with AIMS and also DSS, found that automated reminders were more effective for adherence to PONV prophylaxis. It also showed a reduction of inappropriate administration of PONV prophylaxis medication to low-risk patients. Automated reminders not only are effective in promoting correct actions, but may also prevent unnecessary prescription of medication, hence reducing drug costs. Although the DSS significantly improved adherence to the PONV guidelines, guidelines adherence decreased to the level before use of the DSS after its withdrawal from clinical routine. Guidelines adherence for high-risk patients by week. Surgical wound infections are relatively common, as they are considered the second most common complications occurring in a hospitalized patient, and the second most common nosocomial infections, occurring in 2% to 5% of surgeries and in up to 20% of abdominal surgeries. They have a significant economical impact, because patients affected spend more time in the hospital and are more in danger to be admitted to an intensive care unit, to be readmitted to the hospital after discharge, or to die. Antimicrobial prophylaxis is most effective when administered before surgical incision, with an optimal time to be within 30 minutes before incision or within 2 hours if vancomycin is administered. In order to facilitate timely administration, DSSs were implemented in AIMS to obtain better adherence with those guidelines. One of these is an automated computer-based documentation that generates automatic reminders to the anesthesia team and the surgeon. In this study, authors found that 70% of all surgical patients received their antibiotics within 60 minutes of incision. After 1 year, the adherence increased to about 92%. Administration of antibiotic, gradually increasing to about 92%. Anesthesia Information Management System screen overlaid by SAM screen. Another DSS for antibiotic prophylaxis, the so-called Smart Anesthesia Messenger, SAM, analyzes AIMS documentation data in real time. Conceived as the final stage of intervention, after implementation in an AIMS, SAM transmits reminder messages to the AIMS screen to improve compliance of antibiotic administration before surgical incision. The addition of real-time reminders and feedback via SAM achieved near 100% compliance. Messages for antibiotic redose. A. Message reminding anesthesia team about need for redose. B. Message about documenting redose. Main window of anesthesia information management system with the electronic reminder. A follow-up study investigated the impact of the same DSS on the redosing of antibiotic therapy in comparison with the use of only AIMS. Redosing could be important to maintain the necessary serum concentration of drug, to reduce the risk of postoperative wound infections in procedures that exceed of two half-lives of an antibiotic drug. In this study, a reminder message of redosing was effectuated every 3 hours, the shortest redose interval in guidelines of University of Washington Medical Center. The SAM detected the eventual administration of the prophylactic antibiotic drug, if necessary. It triggers an internal timer specific to that antibiotic and generates reminder icons 15 minutes prior to the time of redosing. These messages are repeated every 6 minutes until the dose is administered and documented.